Hello, I'm Dan Wisey with the Lessman Instrument Company. Today's video looks at detecting thermocouple drift using Honeywell controllers. Before we get into the details in the live demo, let's look at what thermocouple drift is and why drift detection is important. Let's start with what a thermocouple is. A thermocouple is made of two wires of different alloys, commonly called dissimilar metals. For instance, a K-type thermocouple is made from chromel and alumel alloys. The alloys produce an electrical millivolt signal that varies with temperature. The pure alloys that form the thermocouple's junction have a low electrical resistance, and the thermocouple's output is true as long as the alloys remain pure. The temperature versus millivolt values generated by a thermocouple are published in standardized reference tables like this one. Electronic instruments use these tables to produce temperature measurement values. Thermocouple drift is the deviation of a thermocouple's output signal from the published values in the standard reference tables. The chart shows a test of several different thermocouples at a constant elevated temperature over time. The center line is zero deviation here from the constant temperature. The dashed lines here and here above and below the center are the standard limits of error. You can see the green, blue, and yellow curves drifting and wandering away from the zero deviation center line over time. The temperature signals from a drifting thermocouple are not true temperature measurements, they are false temperature measurements. Drift detection is important for two reasons. The first reason is that thermal processing suffers when the control temperature is not a true temperature. The second reason is that the chemical reactions that cause drift eventually cause the thermocouple to burn out or break. An open thermocouple shuts down the heat and brings production to a halt. Both faulty processing and halted production are important business considerations for thermal processors. Drift detection is caused by ion migration, a form of corrosion. High temperatures excite ions in the protection sheath, the protection tube, or the atmosphere. These excited ions mix with the alloy metals, polluting the pure alloys at the thermocouple junction. The hotter the exposure temperature, the more quickly the ions pollute the alloys. The chemical change in the alloy metals also produces increased electrical resistance at the junction. In the K-type thermocouple example, the alloy metals are no longer pure chromel and pure alumel alloys, but are some unknown impure alloy of an unknown chemical makeup. Impure alloys produce a millivolt output that does not correspond to the values in the published standardized table. The problem is that the temperature controller interprets the millivolt electrical signal according to the published tables, but a millivolt output from a polluted junction has no published table. The result? Drift. Temperature readings from a drifting thermocouple are not true temperature readings, they're bogus temperature readings. Drift can be plus or minus above or below the true value. As you can see, the green curve drifts upward and the blue curve drifts downwards. The magnitude of the drift can be large or small, as indicated on the graph. There is no known way to correct for drift other than replacing the sensor with a new thermocouple made from pure alloy. Although there's no means to correct for drift, there is a method to detect thermocouple drift. Honeywell controllers detect thermocouple drift and provide two-stage alarming. Honeywell calls its method thermocouple health monitoring. The actual detection method involves measuring the resistance of the thermocouple input circuit. A new thermocouple has a resistance of less than an ohm. A high resistance measurement indicates that the thermocouple is drifting, and even higher resistance indicates that the thermocouple is near failure. The controller's drift detection provides two staged alarms, TC warn and TC fail. These two stages are similar to tornado alerts. A tornado watch is a cautionary alert. A tornado warning, on the other hand, is an emergency state. A tornado watch is similar to the first stage alarm, TC warn, which warns that the thermocouple is drifting. Tornado warning is like the second stage alarm, TC fail, which calls for immediate action to prevent burnout and process shutdown. This is a diagram of the simulated drift detection with a UDC controller. A decade resistance box is used to simulate a polluted high resistance thermocouple junction in order to demonstrate the drift alarm. The alarm outputs are wired to an alarm annunciator that looks like a traffic light. On the UDC faceplate, the temperature is shown in the upper display here. The set point is shown on the lower display here. And the LED indicators in the upper left up here indicate the alarm status. Alarm number one is going to be TC warn, and alarm number two is going to be TC fail. The green lamp down here, when it turns on, indicates no fault. Now we'll switch to the live demo. You'll see in the live demo we have the traffic light annunciator and a UDC 3500. Everything is normal. Temperature is displayed in the upper display, and the green lamp being on indicates no alarms. But watch what happens when I insert 100 ohms of resistance into the circuit. The yellow lamp turns on, the number one alarm indicator comes on the controller's upper left display, and the lower display temporarily flashes TC1 warn, telling us that the thermocouple is drifting. I'll do this again so that you can see it. I'll turn it off, take it out so it goes back to normal, and then reinsert 100 ohms of resistance into the thermocouple circuit. The yellow light comes on. Up in the upper left-hand corner, we see that alarm number one is on, and the display says TC1 warn. Now watch what happens when I insert an additional 100 ohms of resistance into the circuit. The red lamp turns on, telling us that the thermocouple is in really bad shape and is near failure. The yellow lamp stays on because the loop resistance is way above its set point. The number two LED alarm indicator in the upper left-hand corner of the display turns on because that's what's driving the output for the red lamp. Eventually, the lower display will say TC1 fail, indicating that the thermocouple is near failure.
The controllers can also send an email on alarm, which is one way of making sure that the message gets up the chain of command. The slide shows an Outlook Express email message sent from a UDC controller. Which Honeywell controllers detect thermocouple drift? Well, the quartered in standalone PID controllers, the UDC 2500, 3200, and 3500, can detect thermocouple drift, as well as Honeywell's process automation controller, the HC900, that has modular I/O. The HC900 provides two digital output pins up here on every analog input function block for the TC warn and TC fail functions. The pins can be tagged and used in configuration logic throughout the HC900 and control station HMI panel, typically as alarms. There is one limitation that you should be aware of: the fixed drift detection levels. Thermocouple lead wire contributes to the total loop resistance. The controller does not know whether the resistance it sees is from lead wire or from a polluted thermocouple junction or both. Thermocouple inputs with a long run of extension wire can have a high resistance that's high enough to appear to be drift but is really resistance due to the lead wire. There is a workaround. The alarm trip levels are fixed and are not adjustable, so you can either use heavier gauge, larger diameter, lower gauge number lead wire, or use the TC fail alarm and redefine it as a first stage alert rather than a second stage alarm. When it comes to detecting thermocouple drift, it's like poker. Something beats nothing. In summary, it's a fact of life that thermocouples exposed to high temperatures drift. Thermocouple drift costs processors time and money and processing errors and lost production. But there is a solution using off-the-shelf commercial Honeywell temperature controllers with thermocouple drift detection and alarming. Thank you for watching.